Hello, I'm Jim Jenkins from Applied Technology Institute. I'm the founder and president of the company. Wanted to introduce you to some video samples from our courses. These video samples are the instructors who actually teach the course, giving you a brief description of what the course is intended to cover, what's unique about the course, and then you actually get to see them present 5 or 6 slides as part of the course to get a feel for the level. In addition, many of the courses we have on our website, sample slides where you may get to see 20 to 50 slides from the course so that you can get a real feel for the technical content. Typically, our courses start with the fundamentals, give you enough information that you can understand design trade-offs and things, attend design review and follow what's going on, and then go on to hit some of the advanced topics, all in typically a 3 or 4 day.
My name is Menachem Levitos. I teach the radar system design and engineering course. The course is a 3-day, actually it is a 4th day course, because there is another fellow teaching a 4th day on the subject of radar tracking, a very good part of the course. The radar system design and engineering is a course that goes into radar in a very detailed fashion. It covers it in a broad way and also in quite a deep fashion. We cover fundamental principle mostly during the 1st day, a little bit during the 2nd. We go into advanced topic that includes antenna, electronically scanned array, active electronically scanned array or AESA. We talk about airborne radar, we talk about synthetic aperture radar, we talk about synthetic wideband. We can cover many advanced topics. Some of these involve cutting edge principles, but normally we cover a portion of what we actually bring in depending on selection made by student. Shall we move here? In this section we talk about solid state active array. That's a topic that has begun to be popular already in the early 80s, but is really coming to, has been coming into its own in the last few years. We are going to discuss up front what this kind of radars are. They are distinguished by some architectural feature and also by technological feature. Both of them are very, very essential for the radar performance. We are going to explain precisely why people are willing to spend an enormous amount of money on radars that are very expensive, because of some unique performance feature that these radars have that cannot be obtained by any other means. We go from that to evolving radar system requirement and how they drive the need for this kind of radar, and we finish by discussing issues at the TR module level, array level, and system level. The TR module being the transmitter receiver element behind each element in the array of such a radar. Next question. What are solid state active arrays? The principal feature are distributed transmit receive module at the radiating element. Technology provides us with higher average transmit power. Architecture provides us with lower microwave losses. The lower losses, to say it up front, are because the power is generated right behind each element, and there are no losses involved in bringing high power into the element through various components and network. On receive, there is a low noise amplifier right next to each element, which causes the noise figure to be driven by very few elements up front, and that corresponds to very, very low losses. There are other elements here. There is more flexibility in auxiliary receive channel formation because you have access to each element after amplification. Not a small matter, reduce high voltage hazard. In the entire system, there is no high voltage. All the voltages are low because high power is only added up in space, not inside the system anywhere. That also means that the plumbing on the transmit side are not heavy duty because none of them have to carry much of a signal into the element, the power being generated at each element separately. A graceful degradation through very large number of circuits, if any percentage of them goes down, the overall performance suffers. There are no few central components to make the system go away. And there is much greater signal stability, part of it because of the technology that is available, but part of it because there is so much averaging available through such arrays on the transmit and also on the receive side. There are pure solid state version, and there are also hybrid version that include partly tube and partly solid state. This kind of module are called microwave power module, and they are very, very specific, used mostly in EW. That, I think, is all for this slide. What can we say about a distributed transmit at the array? The power amplifier is available at each radiate the antenna element. That means lower transmit losses, lower power within the system, which are all these elements that I discussed relative to the first slide. However, power supplies and cooling now have to be done at the array itself. In conventional systems, there is a transmitter in the back, and the array only conveys that energy and drops it and dumps it into space. But the power is not generated at the array. Here, the power is actually generated at the array. And that means that the array consists of a much larger part of the radar system than in traditional antenna or array. Next, please. Distributed receiver at the array, low noise amplifier at each antenna element means low receive losses. It means that you have access to individual element after amplification. That means that you can have multiple receive channel, and eventually you can end up in some cases in totally digital arrays. The low noise amplifier, however, is not protected by space filtration, meaning that in conventional system, when you form the beam first and add the low noise amplifier afterward, side lobes are formed ahead of the low noise amplifier, and therefore large interference coming from the side lobe is not going to tax the power, the low noise amplifier very much. However, in that system, side lobe interference will not be filtered in space by an antenna up front because there is only a single element there. On the other end, main beam interference will not tax it as much either because of the same reason. So that is a property that has different faces and different interpretation. Now, going to the individual element, multiple receive channels together with the greater improvement in processing power that is available today can transform this kind of an antenna into a truly sci-fi type of a system. And there are systems that are going in that direction, although at a low frequency where there are fewer elements, the advance in that direction is greater. Can you switch back? I think that I cover all of that. Next, please. Now, here is the major advantage of active phased array, and that's something that needs to be understood. Passive architecture will take a small signal put it through a power amplifier, send high power signal into the inputs to the antenna through cables, through power distribution network, etc. We assume here in this example that we take 3 dB of loss, meaning half the power getting lost, and then from this 30 kilowatt going through all this circuitry, 15 kilowatt get radiated and 15 kilowatt is converted into heat. Here we look at the active array architecture. I'm going to send 60 watt here, which is still a very low signal, put it through the entire network that caused a 3 dB loss here. This 3 dB loss represents 30 watt turning into heat.